The worst economic collapse since the Great Depression. That's what happened to the U.S. economy in the April to June quarter, according to government data released on Thursday. GDP, the broadest measure of economic activity, shrank 32.9% in the second quarter in the biggest economic dive since the government started keeping records in 1947. That was more than triple the previous all-time decline of 10% seen back in 1958. Much of that weakness came in April when the economy grounded to a halt with stay-at-home orders forcing the closure of restaurants, bars, factories, and many other businesses. Since then, many states have tried to reopen with varying degrees of success. New coronavirus cases have spiked in many of those early states, forcing them to scale back those efforts. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell warned this week that early signs of a bounce back are now at risk as the virus persists.
As we have emphasized throughout the pandemic, the path forward for the economy is extraordinarily uncertain and will depend in large part on our success in keeping the virus in check.
Thursday's devastating report comes as Congress and the White House face a Friday deadline when an extra $600 a week jobless benefit is due to run out. Economists point to the record aid that's already come out of Washington as a major reason why the economy has started to stabilize after the record drop in the spring. But the recovery, still in its early days, is likely to be slow, says Mizuho Securities chief economist Steve Ricciuto.
And I think the recovery is going to take time. However, against that backdrop, year-over-year growth rates in GDP could be back to zero by the second quarter of next year. That doesn't mean the economy's back to the level it was prior to the shutdown, but it does mean that the bulk of the deterioration will be behind us within a one-year period of time.
And this slow rebound is still shedding jobs. More than 1.4 million people signed up for first-time jobless benefits last week. All told, over 30 million Americans received some type of government unemployment assistance during the month of July.